Gen Y, Gen X, Millennials, Generation Me, Generation Internet. You know who you are. You've been crushed, hit hard by this economy.
So if you're dealing with college debt, I mean, maybe you're even trying to move out of your parents' house or start a new business. Look, the only way you're going to be able to do that is to be able to produce and to get people to pay you what you're worth.
I'm fighting for your generation. I'm not counting you out. I believe in you. We're here to give young hustlers the advice and tools they need to succeed in the 21st century. Hustlers, my man Jared Glantz sitting right next to me, calling him Casper today. I'll introduce you to this young man here in a second. Welcome back to the Young Hustlers. Appreciate you taking time. You guys 18 to 32 years old as I eat my cherry shower. Sour, cherry shower. It's so sour.
Cherry.
I can't even say it. I say sherry, not cherry. My name's Grant Cardone. On Twitter, I'm at Grant Cardone. Millennials. Look, you guys are being counted out by every generation that preceded you, okay? Every group. I'm talking about derelicts. Rappers are starting to turn on you. Everybody's saying 18 to 32, lazy, useless, ADD'd, can't focus, don't care. All you can do is text. Hey, as I swallow my cherry sour, I'm going to tell you something, all right? I'm not counting you guys out, okay? I think you're the brightest generation that's come around in a long time. I think you guys got a lot of hip and swag and intelligence that other people aren't paying attention to. I was told as a baby boomer, buy a house, save your money, have a good job. And you guys are like, dude, I ain't buying a house. Saving money, no, that's not what I'm going to do. I'm going to invest the money. The smart guys are investing money to make a swing. And buying a house, last thing generation Y or millennial wants to do is go hunker down in a house and be tied down. And that has been made even more true today for me, hearing things like, we can't hire Gen Ys and millennials, we can't hire young people because they can't focus and they don't want to work and they don't want to show up and they want to change jobs. I got a guy here today with me, Val Lefevre. How do you say it?
You got it.
Is it right?
Lefevre.
Now this cat, he is the perfect example of why I do this show and why I do what I do for a living. He... 21 years old, okay? Looks like he's like 19.
That's because I just shaved, actually.
When do you, how many languages do you speak?
Two fluently, and then I can like hustle in Italian.
Okay.
And when faking in Spanish, too.
And go ahead and pull that up a little closer. All right. When do you use French?
You
only use it when? What did you tell
me? No, the French accent. When I speak English.
Yeah, when you move into your French, when do you move into French? Who do you save it for?
I saved a French accent in English for the ladies.
For the ladies, man.
I'll keep it for the end.
Once you say in French, I got something special for you. How would you say that?
In French accent?
Yeah. No, French, yeah.
J'ai quelque chose spécial pour toi.
Oh, I even want some. So look, hey, you're listening to Val here. He's 21 years old. He lives in San Francisco now, but he also lives in Paris. You want to tell everybody how you got introduced to me?
All right. So it's a story that goes back 2.5 years ago. When I actually hustled my way to my first internship after my first year in college.
And that was doing what?
So my college was business school. It was, business school.
Yeah.
And after the summer, they said, okay, you guys have to find an internship. And I knew I wanted to do an internship in the English-speaking country. And I wanted to do in finance.
America, right? I mean, you mean America.
I mean American.
You didn't mean Canada, did you?
So I'm like, all right, I'm going to find an internship in a...
Everybody wants to come to America.
In a financial industry in America. So I actually managed to find an internship in a debt collection agency. It was called Oliphant Financial back in Tampa, underneath Tampa. And so I landed there knowing nothing about financial...
What year was this?
2011.
Okay. All right. So the job market hadn't quite come back yet.
No. And we're talking about, financial industry. So financial debts, credit card, all that stuff.
Right? Yeah.
And so I landed there... And as a debt broker, intern. So cold calling, actually.
Cold calling, dude.
First dip.
21 years old. Well, then you were what?
No,
19? 18?
No, I was still 18.
18 years old. He hadn't even had sex yet, okay?
Except actually, I left himself. My girlfriend back in France. So I was like,
okay. Okay. But even her, she's still a virgin, okay?
She was.
So look, check it out, okay? This kid, 18 years old, comes to America from Paris, right? Doing an internship, not getting paid any money. And you know what he says? Dude, give me a phone. Give me somebody I don't know. I want to call them. This guy's a young hustler. So you Gen Ys or Gen Xs, I'm sorry, you baby boomers, you say he won't do the work. Here's one. Here's a guy that's willing to do the hustle. When we come back from break, he's going to walk you through how he got introduced to me, what he did, how he got here today. Dude, this guy is the perfect example of why so many Americans deserve to be without work. Here's a guy coming from another freaking country saying, hey, man, I want to put my hustle on in the hustle country of the planet, America, the great USA. Stay with me. This is Grant Cardone and Jared Glant, Casper at Jared Glant. You can hit me on Twitter at Grant Cardone. Stay with me.
Whatever you want, you got to commit all the way in and think in terms of domination, not a spectator. You don't want to be a spectator, folks. Spectators pay, players get paid. There's not a second, a third, a fourth, or a fifth. It's just first or nothing. Improvements in products comes from competition. But if you're the one playing the game, you want to dominate the field.
Your power base is your lifeblood. It's everyone that you know. And it starts very small. It starts in your immediate circle and branches out from there.
People underestimate this all the time. In this book, Grant tells you who your power base is, how you contact them, in what order, and exactly what you do.
Now, how do you do that in your business? Follow-up, emails, phone calls, persistence, personal visits. Dominate your buyer's thinking.
So if you want to learn how to outwork the competition with effective strategies, got to get If You're Not First, You're Last. Grant covers exact strategies on what you need to do so that you can actually push, advance, and dominate your marketplace.
Look, I'm a self-made guy. I came from Louisiana. I was greatly inspired by some losses in my life. And it really, somehow that ignited this fire, if you will, in me to do everything I can with the time that I do have. It was just a turnaround moment. It was that moment where I'm like, okay, you're either going to break and become nothing here, or you're going to turn this thing around and become something that even you can be proud of. And so for the last 30 years now, I've just been on a search to make myself the best I can be, create companies that attract great people, create possibilities for myself, my friends, and my family, and my community that I could be proud of. I really approach success as a duty now, not as an option, as a responsibility and even an obligation to create success for myself. Whatever you want, you got to commit all the way in and think in terms of domination, not a spectator. You don't want to be a spectator, folks. Spectators pay, players get paid. There's not a second, a third, a fourth, or a fifth. It's just first or nothing. When you're selling products and services, you have to know that your products and services are good or you're going to quit selling them. There's two types of people. People that are going to get what they want and the life they want, and everybody else. Hey, what'd you do with that client today? Well, I informed him on the product. Oh, I did a great job. They like you? They love me. Did you close them? No. Then you didn't do anything for them. Look, if you want to get rich, you want to be really successful. When I say rich, I'm not talking about money. I'm talking about a rich life, freedom, time with family, choices. You must learn to dominate. About sales is this: a sale is always made. You can't get away from this idea that you just have to sell more. The truth is, your money is in closing a deal.
Grant Cardone saved my business.
He's believable, and he speaks from his heart, and it doesn't matter whether you're reading it or listening to his audio, you can just really, really feel him.
7 billion people on planet Earth. There's a small portion of them that want greatness. All the great wars that have been won, all the great ventures on this planet, full commitment. Burn the ships, we're going ashore, no way out, let's roll.
Hey, back here, Young Hustlers with Grant Cardone, Jared Glant, who's missing in action right now, we'll call him Casper. Hit him up at Twitter at Jared Glant. Where you at, Casper, white boy? And then I got my new best friend, Val, 21 years old, millennial, in from France. Okay, I just want to give you a little data here. This is my best friend today, my newest, youngest best friend. And I could just pour admiration over you, dude. If I had a bottle of it, I'd just hit you with it right now because I love you so
right
much.
Right back.
Millennials, millennial generation, Gen Y, demographic cohorts. This is on Wikipedia, which is, I don't even know why I'm reading off of Wikipedia because it's such an untrusted site. However, you can get a little bit of data there. It's decent. Somewhere between 1980 and 2000, these things called millennials or Gen Ys, man, the amount of garbage written about this group of people. How about this? Do you know you're the Peter Pan generation?
Like in Dreamland?
Peter Pan, dude. Yeah. That's what they call you, the Peter Pan generation, okay?
Like I need to grow up?
Yeah, whatever that means. You know, problem with attention spans, problem with job commitments, problem with showing up, problems with can't communicate to people, they just text. Well, I'm going to tell you, this cat right here is why I do this show, because every week, me and Jared Glant, at Jared Glant, follow him on Twitter, okay, come on this show called Young Hustlers, and we can basically give people information about what the young group. And look, you could be young physically or young at heart or 55 years old and say, dude, I want to act like a player. We come here to talk about guys like this that are making it, okay? Now, Val grew up in Paris, right?
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere outside of Paris. Yeah. You just say Paris because...
I'm from Paris. I'm born in Paris, but I grew up like next to Switzerland in the Alps in the mountains.
Okay.
But I went back to college next to Paris.
Okay. Yeah. He comes to San Francisco. He's picking up the story where he comes to San Francisco, gets an education, gets an internship in Tampa.
Mm-hmm.
Nimble, ain't Peter Pan, baby. It's Jack be nimble, Jack be quick, Jack jump over my big candlestick, okay? So he moves to Tampa and starts doing cold call and pick the story up right there.
Yeah, so basically I actually started, like, I knew nothing about financial industry. I picked and I arrived there 18 years old, like very hungry, right?
Yeah.
And so I was sitting in the boss room and he was explaining to me, like, you know, the basics of how you buy portfolios of distressed debt and then collect it and then sell it back. And so I picked up a couple books and read about it, and then I was like asking him all those relevant questions. He's like, and then he tested me. Are you up for, you know, making some business with that? I'm like, damn, down, right? Uh-huh. And so he actually gave me a call and said, okay, that's an Excel spreadsheet. We had like, I don't know, a couple hundred people to call. There you go, call them, sell them. Those.
So he gave you a list. He basically gave you the Glengarry, Glenn Ross list.
There you go, is make something out of it.
Right.
So I was like one office.
And alone. You said, I want some coffee. And he said, hey, dude, coffee's for closers.
I don't drink coffee.
Okay.
I just
call. Right. Okay.
So actually I'm like, all right, well, let's make that happen. But then remember, I was still picking up about what I'm doing.
Yeah. Now he's mid school. You hadn't finished school at this point.
First
right?
year of college.
First year of college. He's doing cold calls. Mm-hmm. Some of you 50 years old, you've been in sales 25 years and you won't do a cold call. I did a show on this last week about nobody wants to do the cold call. There's even websites that say, cold calls are over. Never make another cold call. Dude, if you don't make cold calls, you're never going to meet people you don't know. Go ahead.
So I didn't know. I never did cold call before. So I didn't even knew the concept and all this, you know, the shadow around it. Like, oh, yeah. That's scary. So I was like, okay, yeah. That's what I have to do. I was here for 3 months. I'm like, I got to prove something, right? So
right.
I just like pick up the phone and started calling all around the U.S. And actually, because there was some context, you know, I was calling on behalf of the company and I was selling relevant stuff to targeted people. I actually went on, you know, you know, like in the right direction, but I still had to pour it in.
Yeah.
So after a month and a half, we I said we because that, on those deals that were hot, I was actually transferring them to the marketing manager that closed the deals. So I wasn't doing the full pipeline.
You were opening up, though. That's the hard part. Find somebody that's interested in your product.
Yeah. After a month and a half, the boss, you know, took me in, and then we started working closely with him. I was done with cold calling, and we'd be building portfolios to buy better distressed debt.
Okay. So when did you get turned on to the videos? You found me on YouTube, right?
Pretty quickly, actually, because, you know, like 2011, turned on YouTube, right?
Yeah.
Oh, how you cold call, how you nail sales.
And pop. Who pops up?
Grant Cardone.
How do you say Grant Cardone in French?
Grand Cardone.
Oh, okay. Grant Cardone. Call me Grant Cardone. So you get turned on to my video.
I'm like, dude, this dude is sick. Like, and I started consuming.
Yeah. Now, just so you guys know, that is my number one way to pull traffic. Worldwide, we in 2009, I said, oh no, I'm not going to target to a zip code anymore. I'm targeting to planet Earth. Val comes in, gets turned onto my data, turns on to Gittermer, Tracy, you told me this in my office, Tony Robbins.
Yeah. All those guys.
He had so much success with this book. What did you do, Val?
I actually went on and translated in French.
Called me up and said, I want to translate to French. A sick commitment, dude. Hey, you baby boomers, bone up like that. Stay with me, this is Grant Cardone on Young Hustlers.
The win, W-I-N, is critical to survival in life. The truth is, your money is in closing a deal.
So first and foremost, you have to understand that the close is truly for the customer. As a salesperson, your job isn't complete until your customer has taken delivery of your product or service. So if somebody comes to me and they have a need that my product can fulfill, it will be unethical for me not to insist that they do business with me today.
Closing to me is ensuring I provide a service to my client. You don't actually provide a service to your customer until you close them.
What you need to know today about this marketplace, about your customer, is the close is everything today. How do I push through resistance? How do I push through the consumer's fear? How do I get them that close and then push them over the edge so we can truly be of service to people?
It is your duty, it's your obligation to ask people to do business with you. If you're not doing that, you're gonna miss out on a lot of opportunity.
Selling is one thing, closing a transaction is something completely different.
I wanted to basically be able to provide a product where I could coach people before, during, and after the sale. And the mobile is the only thing that allows me to do that so that Grant Cardone is accessible to the professional salesperson that wants to become better. Close the Sale app guarantees to make you a master negotiator and closer because it handles every situation you will face. Close the Sale app is geared to all professional salespeople, all new salespeople, all veteran and highly experienced salespeople. The most unique feature about this app is the multitude of closes that are designed to fit different personalities and different situations. I am going to give you the words, the tools, and the exact strategy to take, and you're going to fit your personality in that situation, and you're going to close it.
Dude, my daughter's 4 years old. She's been singing that for 2 years. I want her hustling. I want her digging for gold. You understand that? All you gold diggers out there, I love a gold digger. Ain't nothing like a good gold digger. I respect my wife because my wife has been digging for some gold. And if you're not digging for gold every day, what do you end up with? Rocks. Sure. Dig, baby. Dig. You got to respect a woman that's out there looking for some guy that's put things together. I met a woman once that told me, dude, I don't go out with anybody but rich guys. I said, really? Why is that? Because you rich guys, you're in control. You've experienced enough discipline in your life to put some bank together. your money is an indicator that you're hustling, man. It's not luck. She's not talking about a rich, lazy guy, and she's not talking about taking something from a guy. I got a guy here, Val. This guy, he doesn't know this yet, but he's in exchange with me more than anybody I know. I mean, the guy gets turned on in my book, Sell or Be Sold, uses the material to make himself better, uses it to make himself an entrepreneur, or at least to fuel the entrepreneur, because I don't think you really make an entrepreneur. You just feed them, okay? Mm-hmm. And takes this book. He's like, hey, man, I want to get to know Grant. He basically says, can I translate your book? Who paid for this? Who paid for the translation?
It's myself. My
he did, dude. My he did. Time. Invested money. And look, here he is today in Miami Beach, Florida, coming through town. His mom's outside. We ought to bring his mom inside and embarrass her. And here he is today. So you find me on YouTube.
Basically, yeah.
You found me and Gittermer. Who's prettier, first, me or first. Gittermer?
I mean, you're rocking boat.
Okay, me or Brian Tracy?
You rocked the boat.
Come on, man. Me or who's the other guy? Oh, Brian Tracy.
Anthony Robbins.
Grandpa. That's Grandpa. Like, yeah. Grandpa. Grandpa Brian.
Grandpa Brian. I mean, there's many. There's Harvey McKay.
No, these guys are all great. Yeah, they're all great. I mean, I respect them. I've learned a lot from them.
But like particularly, I'm particularly fond of the American like style of doing business, and you represent it. You know, like as I said in your office, you're like in your face, right?
Yeah.
You're like, boom, I'm here.
Dude,
to
I want
to
give you a heart attack, dude. I don't want to motivate you. I want to give you a freaking heart attack. And pay attention to me.
It's about, you know, like when you bring that, you know, that vibe, that enthusiasm, that energy, actually, like you just pump up the room, right?
Yeah.
And if you want things moving forward, you have the drive. You just like, you know, like one said, when people said, you know, sale is a transfer in enthusiasm.
Yeah.
That's basically what you do all day.
Yeah.
Just transfer energy, enthusiasm.
So
and I felt that in your videos.
Yeah. So but that's good. That's one thing. You felt that in the videos. But did anything happen for you on the phone? Because
yeah, I mean, I basically changed toward like, you know, I was supposed to do calls. I was making calls. Mm-hmm. But then it changed when you find a guy like him and understand his content and then try to apply it to yourself. It just changed the whole game because you're not mechanically doing calls. You're actually playing that game and trying to win, right? And you do it in a professional. In a professional way, in the sense that, like, the content and the expertise is there. You just have to have the curiosity and discipline to consume and then apply it to yourself.
Yeah, and you got to
go in the field and then try it.
Yeah, and you got to be interested enough. I mean, you know, one of the reasons I do some of the stuff that I do is not to be the hard hitting, you know, American, but if I want to get someplace, I hit the accelerator. I mean, and I'm trying, in many cases, when we do our programs here, audio, video, whatever, I'm trying to get people's attention because it's like a heart attack. It's very similar to a heart attack, dude. Most people don't pay attention to their heart until it has an attack. And then you're like, okay, I need to give that attention. I need to take care of this. And the same thing in your business, okay? Whether you're 18 years old, 32 years old, somewhere in between, my man here is 21. Dude, I got to get your attention to go to the next level. Then I got to get your attention when you get to this level to go to that level.
Push you forward.
So let's talk about levels. Because this cat showed me an app today that he's got.
You can find it.
HotScore.
Yep.
Okay.
That's the name.
HotScore.com, dude. Go to his website.
HotScore
check it out.
HotScoreApp.com.
Okay. Now tell him what HotScore is. Now, this has all happened in the last 3 years since you got turned on, right?
Yeah, actually, like, you know, there's a little story in between, but that's my latest venture, if you will. And it's basically an iPhone app where you log in with Facebook. And what it gives you is your profile. And what happens, it shows you one against the other in a match, people of the opposite sex in your area, right?
Well, opposite sex, unless you're into the same sex.
Unless you persistently say, oh, I'm interested into the opposite sex.
Yeah.
Right? And so it shows you, you know, girls in your area, and you basically have to vote for the hottest, right? Two pictures.
Here, let me show it while you're talking about it, okay? So,
and so you
and
click.
We can click into this later, get a little closer. But
the concept is very simple.
Basically, I can hit this chick right here. Nah. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, Emma. Okay, I gave Emma something, okay?
And what happens is when you actually hit it, it actually gives them a score, which is the ratio of the wins out of number of votes. So the concept is pretty simple to
yeah,
to
so I got it. People can look at it.
Yeah.
Holy, that's good. Damn, my biceps look good.
So that's funny. That's cool. It's like entertaining. People go there like, oh, I get it. I just play.
Yeah, like Hemion, Herion. Is that a woman or a transvestite right there? How would I know?
I mean,
okay, so I'm going to find somebody in here hot, okay? Yeah. Why is this chick with a guy? I'm not going to give her a rating.
That's her profile picture, and she can change it.
Okay, this chick right here, she's pretty hot, Virginia, okay? Mm-hmm. So I'm going to give her, boom, she's a 51.
You vote for her. And
now,
then,
I give her a 51, but what if I'm like a 94?
Well, if you're, the concept,
I'm way up there, right?
The concept is, it's all about your score. So if you have a higher, hotter score,
yeah,
you get to choose who you want to talk to below your score.
Oh, I can talk to anybody below me.
Equal or below. So it actually gives the power to people that are hotter. right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, then we can see the ranking list.
But 51 can't see me yet.
They can't see you.
Dude, you need this app, dude. No, no, because you got a chick now.
I'm done.
Okay.
It's never done.
Off the market.
It's never done? Oh, yeah, I'm done, dude. I'm done. I got the chick, okay? I got a 99 out of a 99.
And so what?
The only reason I can't get my wife 100 is because...
The ratio, the number.
Yeah, it's ugly. You can't
There's always room for improvement.
Well, you can't go around saying, hey, she's perfect.
But here's the thing. The screen now is like the rankings, because when you're done voting, it shows you people you just voted for in ranks. And, you know, the recents, just one you just voted for, and you see their score, and you have your score on the top.
So I just have them come over to the house in this order. Okay, you're at 9, you're at 10, you're at 11. Stay with me. This is Jared Glenn on Jared Glenn. I've been getting you Twitter followers today, y'all. My man Val, can't even say his last name. I just can say he's Val Cardone. Grant Cardone here on Twitter. I'm at Grant Cardone. Stay with me. We're going to be right back with the Young Hustlers. White, baby. Let us know you're watching.
Grant Cardone saved my business.
About 6 months ago, I found Grant Cardone on YouTube, and I instantly liked what he was saying. I wanted to know how to go out and get the sale. I wanted to know when I wanted money, how to turn the faucet on and get money. I call that money on tap. And Grant Cardone taught me how to get that stuff.
Whatever it takes, do what you gotta do, go get it, what you want in your business and in your life.
I need a new guru, somebody who's really up to date and modern, and that's when I found Grant Cardone. And that's when I found 10X.
Look, massive, 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 massive action.
What are you waiting for? You're either gonna have more or you're gonna have less. Make the decision, get committed, read the books, get to the seminars, take action.
If you're trying to build a massive brand, I think there's nobody better in the country than Grant Cardone.
Hey, Grant Cardone here, and by this time you've probably heard the news. Yeah, it's true. What you've heard is true. I definitely did go too far. My attorneys have told me to, you know, kind of be careful about making this video, but I do want to take the time to apologize to you, to my fans. I especially want to apologize to my family, my two little daughters. I hope when they grow up they're able to understand this. Apologize to my wife. All of you that follow me on Twitter and Facebook and YouTube, you guys that have supported me for years, I apologize. I know that I went too far. I know that I did too much. I take full responsibility for it. And while I regret it, okay, like the rants, okay? Look, I knew I was getting carried away last year with the rants. We did 150 rants. Some of them were over the top. The 23,000 tweets, dude, it was a lot of tweets. It was crazy. Some of them were just way over the top. The Santa tweet, my staff took it down. It was so over the top. The Miley Cyrus tweets, the tweets to Obama and to the governor of California, okay? The Chris Christie tweets, the Sears tweet, the Macy's, the Penny's, the retail tweets, okay? It was insane, man. So while I regret offending anyone that follows me, dude, if that offended you, wait and see what I do this year. It's gonna be freaking over the top crazy, okay? It's gonna be arrest level crazy on Twitter. You gotta follow me on Twitter, because this year I promise you at least 30,000 tweets over the next 12 months that will inspire you, will motivate you, and will show you how to take you, your business, and your family to another level, baby. I'm taking Twitter to jail.
Yeah, boy!
Come on,
where you been,
man?
Casper? We've been calling you Casper.
Casper. I've been doing deals, man.
Hey, welcome back. This is Grant Cardone on Young Hustlers with Jared Glant, at Jared Glant. I got my man Val Cardone. We've made him a Cardone now. And we're talking today about millennials, what you have to do to think different. Here's a cat, came out of college. I think you learned how to cold call.
Yeah, I did.
Picked up my videos on YouTube.
Actually, yeah.
Got my book. took the book, translated the book. Dude, he just didn't read the book. I know some of you bought my book, didn't read it. I know a bunch of you didn't buy the book yet, but you keep saying, I'm going to get to it. This cat buys the book, translates the book, pays for the translation himself. Commitment, bro. Then what does he do? Starts an app. This probably isn't the first thing you've done.
No.
Hotspots.com.
Hotscore app.com.
Okay. Now, you can basically go on here and rate chicks.
It's like hot or not.
Yeah.
Hot or not. It's like Tinder.
I love this. Okay. Better. So I'm going to rate chicks. Now, they can't rate me. No, they can rate me. They can keep pushing my score up. Mm-hmm.
So basically, like, you log in and it shows you people in your area.
Yeah.
And you decide, you know, if you're interested in the opposite sex or not. And then you vote for the hottest.
See?
Right? You vote for
there's anything wrong with that.
I mean, because people are like, oh, can you vote, you know?
Yeah,
I mean,
whatever.
Basically, by default, you're interested in the opposite sex.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what I mean.
Yeah.
And then you vote for the hottest, and as you vote, it actually gives them a score, which is like the ratio of the wins out of number of votes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Pretty simple. And then you get to see the rankings of the people you just voted for, and also the city rankings.
Now, this is like other apps. There are some apps
that do similar kind of thing where it shows you people, and you can say yes and no.
Yeah.
How are you different?
So how are you
different from Tinder?
Okay, so
dude, that cat's different than a lot of people I've met.
Yeah, but like the app itself is different.
You got Tinder on your phone, don't you?
No, I don't. I deleted
it. You deleted it.
You got a girlfriend now.
Yeah.
I mean, so Hotscore is different in a way where it shows you people one against the other. So you have to vote right now, like which one's your favorite, like which one you prefer, which one's the hottest, and this actually gives them influence the score of both. And the scores are important.
Yeah,
because that actually, you know, shows you the rankings.
I'm out with Emma, can she see that I voted for Fiora and she's hiring?
No, she won't see that actually.
Okay.
But she comes in and
unless she grabs my phone, she grabs my phone.
You try to cover the backside, right? Make sure she can't snoop through and find out.
The backside is a French thing.
But the concept is
the whole backside was invented by the French.
Here's the voting part is a cool thing. The real deal is in the rankings because in the rankings
didn't the French create anal sex? Didn't they? Isn't that a French thing, dude?
I don't know. I don't want to go in that background though.
I think that's true, dude. But go ahead.
It's probably in the Bible.
Yeah.
So the voting part.
I don't know why you got to bring the Bible.
The voting part is the funny part.
It's the
cool part, right?
Yeah.
It engages you. But then the real meat is in the rankings, where you see the people you just voted for, and also you see the city ranking. And here's what happens: you have a score. Everybody has a score, and this actually, you know, tells you who you can contact based on your score. So people
you can go down. You can't
equal
can't
or go below. Up.
Can't reach up. Which can't I don't up. Like that. Dude.
If people vote you up,
your score is influenced all the time. People are voting for you,
right,
so it goes
right.
up and down. So actually, your chances are in a certain range. So you get to meet people in a certain range because if you're equal or higher, you can go talk to them directly.
So what's the story? What's the story then? The story with Val is. Is commit,
dude? He
commit before you got any.
Yeah,
any,
that's one.
Anything,
commit
no?
first.
Yeah.
Okay. Number two, all millennials are not lazy, unfocused, not interested.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, I mean, it's ridiculous. Every generation does this. It just pisses me off. Every generation talks about the new generation coming up that they're less than lazy, not focused. Like I still have to be, you know, chipping rocks out of the ground. For my grandfather to think that I worked hard or something.
Right.
It's ridiculous, dude. Look, everybody's got hustle in them. Everybody. I guarantee you, if you're lazing on the couch at 18 years old, dude, I spent hours and hours doing nothing. I was counted out by so many people, my uncle, my aunts, my mom. My family was like, God, you know, there's nothing there. It's not going to happen. Yeah, there's an entrepreneur waiting for the right acknowledgement, the right affirmations, the right environment, the right machinery to sit in,
content.
And you'll rock it, dude. So quit, just commit first.
And then dream big.
You gotta take action though, because everybody, a lot of people have good ideas, great ideas.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah.
But without action,
execution.
Without commitment and execution.
Mm-hmm.
And we see that around here, right? Totally. Guys coming in, I wanna work with you, Grant. I wanna be here. I wanna hang out with you. My name's Grant Cardone. You're on Young Hustlers.
JG at Jared Glant on Twitter.
Val, what's your Twitter handle, bro?
It's my last name, so it's confusing, but it's like Val Lefebvre. Lefebvral.
Yeah.
Basically, at Lefebvral.
Lefebvre.
You got to change it.
Lefebvre.
You got to get that. But look, this guy, hey, man, if you like the show today, okay, the kid's going into the game, bro. You know what? This is the Seattle Seahawks right here, man. He's like, hey, I'll take on Peyton Manning. Let's go. I'm going to bust him. I'm going to overwhelm him so big. We need to do a show on that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to overwhelm him so much, so bad, so big, they're going to forget their game. Omaha, this! Young Hustlers, baby. Thanks for tuning in. Every Thursday, 1 p.m., Young Hustlers. Be there.